तुम्हें लाइट ऑफ कर, ऑन कर भाई। हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग
मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
ये बच्चों के रेगुलर फीस कहीं नहीं, ये स्पेशल वाली आदि के लिए कल आ रहा है। शर्मा कल से कल भेजी की तुम्हारे कल छोड़ो त्यौहार है। वैसे भी आज के बाद तो उसको सारे त्यौहार हमारे साथ ही करते हैं। निकल ले वो त्यौहारों में भूल जाकर निकला
है मुझे। गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
Good morning, good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am.
Hello,
ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Good
afternoon.
Mama, मम्मा इसमें क्या करेंगे? तो बुलाइए गुट्टू दीदी को, करेंगे
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yes. Hi, everyone. We will be starting with the class exactly at 1 p.m. Okay? So be ready with all the material and we will be starting the class.
टीचर को
बन जाएंगे,
कोई दोस्त ही नहीं है। गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून
मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड
आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am. How are you, ma'am?
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yeah.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon,
ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, teacher.
Good afternoon, teacher.
Good afternoon, teacher. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
इन्हें लेके बैठ गई जैसे इनका ही काम। अंदर चढ़ा है नहीं?
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good afternoon, 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 ma'am.
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम.
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम.
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम.
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम.
स्टार्ट
பண்ணுங்க. गुड आफ्टरनून मैम. ऑन करे तक मैं क्लियर है. क्लियर है मुझे. ब्रश किस मैम. मैम आप सी रही हो रहे.
मैम को रोटी के खाना
खोल ले. तो वो बोलते हैं पहले तुमसे कुछ बता
दूंगा. गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
Good morning,
madam.
Good morning, madam. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone. Am I audible to all of you? You have to give me a thumbs up, okay? If you are saying yes, you have to show me a thumbs up. And if you're saying no, what do you have to do? You have to show me a thumbs down. Very good. Okay. And when showing a thumbs up, it should be a smile always. Not just a thumbs up. Okay. How many of you are excited for the Christmas? Christmas is coming and we all must be very excited for it. Hai na? Why are we so excited for the Christmas? My voice is low. Is my voice low? Okay, whatever question you have, if you have any question, you can put it in the chat box, okay? I'll answer it immediately. Yes, so are you ready with all the material? How many of you are having A4 size drawing copy? And a bangle also. We will be needing a bangle as well for today's class. Voice is cracking. Okay, give me just a minute. I'll check it. Yes. Put all the students on mute because we have a large number of students in this class. We have more than 500 students, okay? So I will not be able to unmute anyone. If you have any question, you can put it in the chat box, right? Yes, you can put it in the chat box. And I will be using an A4 size sheet today. So let's get started. Everyone ready? First of all, I'll give you a brief of the material that we are going to use today, okay? So we will be using a drawing copy. We will be needing a bangle, a regular size bangle, a pencil, an eraser, thank you, Aisha. And we will be needing cotton, okay? Cotton and Fevicol. We will need the Fevicol also. Right, very good. Students are showing me, and few more stuff we will be needing is black sketch pen. Do you all have black sketch pen? Yes, very good. And the colors we will be using today is... We will be using today is plastic crayons. Okay, we will be using plastic crayons. You all have plastic crayons with you? Very good. Okay. Okay, before we start, I want to show you. We recently conducted one more activity and we did Santa. Do you like it? This is the Santa we made in the last class, but in today's class, we are going to learn something little different. Okay, so let's get started. So first of all, you have to keep your copy. Yes, those who don't have plastic crayons, they can use either oil pastel or wax crayons also. If you have pencil colors, you can use pencil colors. No, wax crayon and plastic crayons are completely different. So if you have plastic crayons, use that. But if you don't have, then you can use wax crayons or plastic crayons. No, we don't need compass. Just a bangle or any circle, any bowl, glass or any plate of this size would be enough. We don't need compass. Okay, very good. So let's start. Let's start with our drawing, our Christmas special drawing. Okay, so first of all, I'll keep my drawing copy vertically like this. Keep your drawing copy vertically. And the size I'm using is A4 size. Okay, smaller one. I'm not using the bigger one. I'm using a smaller drawing file. Now place your bangle. Place your bangle in the center of the page, exactly in the center.
any pencil. I'm using a regular HB pencil that we use to write. Okay, there is no specific pencil. We are just going to do normal drawing. And you know, while using, make sure your pencil is not too sharp, like instantly sharpened one. No, we will not use that. We will use a lightly blunt pencil. Okay, if your pencil is blunt, that is completely okay, because that is easy to erase. Sharp pencil leave lines, which does not look good. Okay, so put your bangle in the center. Glue, Fevistick, anything you have. And glue or Fevicol would be more preferable. But if you have Fevistick, we can try that too. Okay. Put your bangle in the center and shift it little right side. Shift it little right side. Like this. Okay. And then hold it with your left hand. Use these two fingers to hold it. And press it like this. Then use your right hand to draw the circle inside. Draw the circle. Okay. Little left side we will use. I'll show you again. Many students are asking me to get started again. We will be getting started again. What I did, I put a bangle in the center. And please note those new students who have joined just now, I will not be repeating now. Okay. Can you all hear me clearly? Show me a thumbs up if you can hear me. All okay. Then use opposite hands. If you are a lefty, then use opposite hands. Okay. If you cannot hear me, or if you're getting the low volume, please increase it, because it is full from my side. Okay, so please increase the volume. And if you cannot hear, you can leave the class and you can join again. That would also help. Okay, now I will keep it in the center and I will shift it little right side. Hold it like this and draw a circle. Okay, I have drawn a circle. Now, you know, from here, I will shift my drawing, my circle left side. And, you know, I'll intersect it like this. No measurement. Be very free with the drawing. I'm giving you an approx idea and that is completely fine. You don't have to be very specific with the measurements and all, okay? We are doing a freehand drawing. Right? So intersect it this much and then draw another circle. We need this kind of shape. Draw two circles intersecting each other like this. If it is not visible, please switch to speaker's view. You will be able to see me. Okay? Yes, whatever doubt you have, put your question in the chat box. I'll answer it immediately. Okay, so now after drawing these two circles, I will zoom it in. Wait, I will zoom in so that you can see. You can see whatever I'm going to do clearly. These are two circles we have made. Okay, now at the bottom part of these circles, I will take a dot this side and a dot this side. Take two dots. Yes, you can use small bangle also, but make sure you use the same bangle to make these two circles. Okay, that is very important. Now what I'll do? I'll make a flat C connecting these two circles like this. You know, I'll draw it in such a way that it looks like this line is continuing till here. Okay? Okay, I put a dot this side, inside this side, okay, and this side. and then I drew a C, a flat C. Okay, now I will take a dot at this point and another dot at this point. We are doing a Christmas special drawing, and this drawing has a beautiful story behind. Okay, I'll tell you the story also, that what are we exactly drawing. Yes, I drew two circles intersecting each other, and then we made a C. We took these two points and we made a C. Okay, and these circles are made in the center of the page. Now I will connect this dot with this dot, again making a big C. Like this. Make a big C. Draw it nicely. A big flat C. I'm sorry, I cannot allow anyone to speak in the class because otherwise students will not be able to see the drawing. Okay, for the bottom part, you have to make a flat C touching. Both the lines should touch the circle. This is very important. Okay? So now what we will do, we will erase these lines inside. Okay, I don't need these two lines and I don't need this outside line also. So I will pick up my eraser and I will erase these lines. Erase the outer line also and we will get a nice shape. We'll get a very nice shape. Okay. If you want, you can make it little bigger also. You know, like this. Little deeper C. You can make it like this. This will look even more good. Okay, so make a nice C. And this is how it should look. Okay, I'm waiting. We are making a Christmas special drawing. This is going to be a little penguin. How many of you know about penguin? You all know about penguin, right? It is a little cute bird. And does it live in desert? Does it live in desert? No, it is found in North and South Pole, hai na? It is found in extremely cold areas. It is a bird of snow. It stays there where we have a lot of snow. And okay. Yes, now I will make a flat C going upwards like this. And this side also, I'll make a flat C. Okay, like this. Make two flat C. Okay. And now I will connect it. Everyone done with flat C? That's okay. You know, when we will complete the drawing, you will love it. Okay. Let the drawing get completed first of all. और Yes. Okay. So now I will connect it. I will connect these two. See. Okay. Now I will make a C and I'll connect it. I'll connect it like this. Okay. Connect it like this. Okay, connect it like this. You know, this edge, make it complete C, complete round it should be. Okay, this is how it should look. Try to make the shape really nice. Yes, yes, I'll do that, Neha. Okay, everyone done till here? Show me a thumbs up if you are done till here. Okay. Okay, I'll go a little slow. Now take 2 points, 1 and 2. On this upper part, take 2 points. And this side, make an S like this. Is my voice breaking, everyone? Is my voice breaking? No. Okay. Thank you so much. I got the message that your voice is breaking. Okay. So now I will make. We have made an S this side, okay? And now you have to have the space, you know, don't make upper area so big that you don't have any space. See, this is how much space I am having. This is the top of my drawing copy, but I'm having this much of space and you should be having that, okay? And if you don't have, you can minimize this area. Now I will make a small C again at this part. Right? Like this. Make a small C. Now connect it with a C again. Make a C again. Make a big C. This is not a Santa. This is actually, we are making a penguin. Okay, but the penguin is going to look like a Santa. Why? Because he has done it for someone. I'll tell you the complete story and you will understand. Okay, so the C, another C. Now we will make one more C and I will connect it like this. Okay, not this much deep, but little deep. And I'll connect it. Okay. And now I will make a circle, a big circle upwards like this. Okay. Starting from this side and make a big circle. Like this. So this is the upper part completed. Right? Yes, you know what I did? Okay, you can take these 2 points also. Okay, take these 2 points and then you can just connect it with a C. Okay, now come downwards. Now come this side and we will work on the face. Okay, so to make the face, take two dots. You know this part, just above this, take two dots, one and two. In front of this dot, we will take this dot, and in front of this, we will take this. Okay? Yes. Now I will make a V. I'll make a V, but the end of the V would be curved like this. So we have to make a shape like this. Right? Yes, this is the upper part. This is the complete drawing. Okay. This is what we have done till now. Now I will again make a U at the bottom part. Let us make a U at the bottom part. And inside this, let us make one more V, but this V would again have not the corner, not the pointed corner, but a rounded corner. So we have made a V with rounded corners and we will make two dots. So this is the beak. This is the upper part. This is the beak of my penguin. Okay. Yes, how many of you are done till now? Show me a thumbs up. Done? How many are still doing? Show me a thumbs down if you are doing and want me to wait. Okay. Okay, few ones want me to wait. So I'll wait for a minute and then we will proceed, okay? I am from Agra, UP. Agra, UP. Very good. Few of the students are showing and they have done so good. Very nice. So now I will take two points on the beak, one this side and one this side, because now we will be making the nose. Okay, so take two points and take a point here on the cap. Okay, one point I have done it here and other point would be here. Yes, I will be checking the drawing of everyone in the end of the class. Okay. Right, now I will take one more dot. See this dot, if you see this dot is in the center of this curve, just above that. From here also, just above this part, I will take a dot. Okay, now I will connect this dot with this dot, making a C again. So it will go straight and then it will be a curve. It will be a curve like this. Okay, now same I will do for other side. I will make a C. I'll make a C from this point till this point. Okay, I've taken these two points just above the beak and above the center of this point. And then I connected them with C. Okay? Everyone done till here? Done. Okay, so let's move further. Now I will make the eyes of little penguin. So to make the eyes, I will make a big circle. Okay, a big circle like this, and another circle here like this. Okay, make sure both the circles are equal. So I have made two eyes. Right? Yes, upper part is visible already in the screen. So I have made two eyes. And now after making the eyes, everyone done with the eyes? Everyone done with the eye part? Okay, completed. Completed. Okay, good. So now I will do another circle inside. Okay, we will do another circle inside in the center like this. Okay, and this side also I'll do another circle which is done like this. So I have done two circles. Okay, inside. Now what I'll do, I'll make one big circle inside the eye. This is the eyeball, and one big circle this side also. Okay, and now everyone done till here? Now I will make one big circle inside. Okay, this side and this circle would come another side. Okay, inside we are making one this side and another this side. Okay. There is one more thing that we still have to do with the eyes, which is we have to make one more circle outside. You know this line? We will make a circle at this point. And here we will make a circle at this point. Okay. So with this, our eyes are complete. What we have done, we made a big circle. Then we made a circle inside. Another circle in the center of this eye. Then we made a small circle. And then we made a circle outside. Okay. So this is what we have done. Now let us make the eyelashes. To make the eyelash, of this, I will make 1, 2, 3. Here also I'll do 1, 2, 3. Okay. Done with the face, everyone? Can you all show me? Please show me your face if you are done with that. I want to see what you have done. And bring it close to the camera. Close to the camera. Very nice. Oh, beautifully done. Very good. That is beautifully done, everyone. Too good. Okay, so let us shift our drawing copy little downwards now. Okay, little downwards like this. And now we will do the bottom part. Okay. Yes, I'm going slow because, you know, we have many young kids also. So we have to go with the flow of everyone, hai na? That is. Otherwise, you know, the classes that we take, in that we go as per the speed of the student. Like we have a junior batch where we go little slow, and in senior batch we go little faster because kids are able to do it. Okay, now we will take two dots, 1 and 2. And I will make a C again, a small C. Both the sides. Okay, in the end of the class, I will be showing my face, okay? And we will be talking, right? Thank you so much, Garima. Thank you. Now I will be connecting it with straight line. Connect it with a straight line. But make sure, you know, every time we are connecting it, we are trying to make one step after another. Try to make it in such a way that it should be the continuation. It should look like the continuation of the drawing. Okay? Thank you so much, Arya. Arya and Deeksha, thank you. Yes. So now let's move ahead. Yes, yes. If you want to go for washroom, if you want to drink water, you don't have to ask for it. Okay, you can go. Now, let us take two dots, one and two. Okay, let's take two dots and let us make a C. We will make a C. Okay, and now I will make a V shape. Okay, so I'll make a slanting line. And I will connect it. First, I have made a line like this. Then with a curve, I'll turn it this side and I'll connect it like this. Okay. I made a straight line. Then I connected it like this. This is how it would go. This is the flipper of a penguin. Okay. Yes, yes, I take online drawing classes. Thank you so much. Okay, I took two dots, one this side and other this side. Okay, then I made a C. I connected a C and then I made a slanted line going outwards. Then with a C, I turned it inside. Okay. So here I have a flipper of the penguin. Now I will take one more dot this side. I'll complete the body. And we will make a C. We'll make a C again. Right? Like this. And we have to connect this C, making another C. We have to connect it like this. Okay, okay. Just a minute. Yes, now you will not be able to see the draw. I will zoom it out a little bit so that you can see the upper part also. Okay. Yes. Now let's make the other flipper. Other side of the flipper is also left, hai na? So I will make a dot at this side. And I will again make a line going outwards. Like this. Then I'll make a line coming inside. Exactly we did it here. Okay. Just like we did it here. We will do it this side also. Exactly the same size. We made the straight line till here. Then we made a curve. And come equal to this. Okay. This is the full drawing. Right? This is the full drawing. And now connect it with a C. So this is, here is our second flipper. Okay. And now let us take two dots in the center and we will complete the body. We will complete the body of our penguin. So I'll make a flat C and I'll connect it. Okay. And here also I will make it, I'll make, and you know, it might go the circle, this you will, which you will make this side, na, it might go inside. So no problem. We will make it half. Okay. Or you can make it like this and you can erase this part later. So this is how it would come out. Okay. And now I will make the feet of the penguin. Okay. So to make the feet part, for this part, I will make one. I'll make a circle. Okay. One. Another circle, two and three. And for the other side also, I'll do the same thing. I'll make a circle like this, one. And then, you know, I'll make the circle behind it. So I will make a C, two and three. And I'll erase this line which is coming inside. How I did it? I made a circle. Yes, yes. RV, I'll do that. Flippers. Okay, I'll repeat it. I made 2 points. I took 2 points and then I made a C first of all. Then I made a straight line. I made a C and I connected it inside. Okay, then I took a point here and I made a big C, which made the whole body, right? Then I made the other flipper. So I took another point, came down. Then again, I made a C just like I did it here. I made a C and then I came down and I made this flipper, the second one. And you know, as my feet is coming over it, I'll end the flipper here only. So that it won't look odd and I'll erase all these extra lines. Okay. I will erase all these extra lines. Yes, it might look like an owl, but you know, when we will color it and when it will get completed, it would look like, it would look like a bird, a penguin. Okay. So now we will make the bag of gifts. And why the penguin is carrying the bag of gifts? This is all about our story. I'll tell you the story that why this penguin is looking like a Santa and he has dressed up himself like a Santa. Okay. So let us take a dot at this point and a dot at this point. Two dots we have taken. And I will make a C. Okay. And I'll connect it here. Right? It is carrying it at the back side. Okay, and this is our complete penguin. This is what our complete penguin should look like. So now let us start with our story. The name of this penguin is, what is the name of this penguin? Its name is Pingu. What is the name? Pingu. Okay. And it has a younger sister. This penguin has a younger sister also, which is just born. Okay. She was just born a few months back, and her name is Tia. What is the name of the Pingu's sister? You can switch to speaker's view. Yes, it is Tia. Okay, so when Christmas was coming, Tia was so excited to see the Santa. Hana, it was so excited that Santa would come. Mom used to say, Tia, that, you know, Santa is going to come and he'll give you so many gifts. And Tia was so excited about it. Tia was so excited to see the Santa. Okay? Yes. Now, we will complete the drawing also and we will keep doing our sketching part. We'll keep completing the sketching part also. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to make the land part also, hana. So let us make a land part as well. You all have done amazing. You know, many students are showing me and I can see they have done so good. And now let us, here we are going to make a Christmas tree. Okay, so let us take a dot at this point and make a big V. 1 and 2. I'll take a line. I'll make a big V. Okay. And I'll make it like this. Okay. I'll make 2 lines and okay, if you don't have any space, you can draw the Christmas tree wherever you have the space. What I did, I took a dot and I made a V shape. And then I connected it with zigzag, zigzag. Okay, I connected it making zigzag, zigzag lines. And this is the full picture only that you are seeing. Okay, and then I made a curved line to end the Christmas tree. Now I will erase this line. Let us erase this line. And you all know how to make a star? Everyone knows how to make a star? Okay, I'll tell you a fun way to do a star. And you know it is going to be the exact star that we make. What to do? Just above this, make another V. Make another V like this. Okay, everyone make the star with me so that you don't miss any of the steps because there are little tiny steps. Okay, now I will make 2 flat lines, 1 and 2. Okay, and for now you can erase this top part. Right? Now I will make I'll make it a V. Okay, a V and a V like this. Okay, I'll show you again what I have done. I'll make a straight line, I'll make a V, and then I'll make a V going like this, downwards. Okay, and then I'll make a V inside. And this is how a five star, a star with five hands, five arms to make. Okay, and then I'll continue it. So here is my star. Okay, and I will make little lights on my Christmas tree. Okay, make little lights. Right? Yes, please put your questions in the chat box. Whatever you want to say or ask, you can put it in the chat box, okay? If you want, you can make some Christmas trees at the back also. And how to make the Christmas trees at the back? You just have to make a V. Make a V. And, you know, till the end, make it like this. And then make small trunk. Okay? Again, if we want to make a Christmas tree bigger than this, you can make it and connect it. So this is how you can make the Christmas trees at the background also. Okay? I'll make one more here also. Just a triangle and this. See how nice it is looking. We have just made this Christmas tree. We made a triangle and we connected it at the bottom and we made the line. Okay, so with this, our drawing is complete. Yes, Arjun, I'll do that. Yes, okay, this is how it is looking. Complete the drawing. And now I will be completing my outline also. Okay, now I will be completing my outline. I will zoom it in so that you all can see the part I'm doing. And I'll do the outline. So pick up your black sketch pen. That is completely okay. See, if you think your drawing is not good, it would never improve. You have to check your drawing, you know, every time you make it, after doing, check your drawing again, that is it looking correct? And if you think, no, this part is not going good, just erase it and do it again. How simple is that? Hannah, we don't have to be worried about, oh, my drawing is not good. If it is not good, then it's your responsibility to make it look good. Okay? Who else will do it? You have to do it, right? Yes, so now I have zoomed in the screen. Now I will start with the outlining part and we will continue with our story as well. So, let us start with the outline. Pick up your black sketch pen and keep doing the outline. Okay. And I'll tell you the story also. So, you know, mom used to tell the little Tia about the Santa, and Tia was so excited to meet the real Santa. But have you ever seen, any one of you, have you ever seen the Santa coming? No, right? Has Santa ever come? We have never seen, because why have we never seen the Santa? because you know it is inside, it is not outside. We keep waiting for the Santa to come, and you know Pingu, he knew that Santa would not come, but she was so excited. Tia was so excited to see that the Santa would come and I would meet him, and I'll talk to him, and I'll ask for so many gifts. So Pingu tried to explain Tia that, but you know, she started getting angry and she started crying. You know, Santa, it's not like that Santa never comes. Santa does come, but there are so many kids, hai na? There are so many kids. So Santa comes in different forms. It comes in different forms. So we have to understand that, right? So in that case, in the case of Tia, she was waiting for Santa, but it was night. It was getting night and Santa did not come. And yes, Lina Bandel is my mom. Lina Bandel is my mom. I'm Ayushi. Okay. Can you all hear me? Show me a thumbs up. Okay. Yes, yes, we will color it also, and we will be doing little bit of craft also. Okay, so yes, so it was getting night and they were waiting for Santa to come, but Santa was busy and it could not come. So, you know, Pingu decided that I will make my sister happy, because she had started crying, you know, she was crying badly that why Santa has not come. This is the upper part. This is the upper part. So Pingu decided that he will get dressed like Santa and so he wore the workshop is also going on. The Christmas workshop. We had a Christmas workshop which was starting today. And it is also going on simultaneously. My mom is taking the workshop and I'm taking this activity. Okay. So he got a cap just like Santa. He wore it. He got a bag and filled it with all the gifts Tia wanted to get from Santa, and he went out of the house and knocked the door. Thak, thak, thak. So Tia got alert. She was like, Mom, is it Santa? And Mom said, there might be. So Tia ran to the door and opened it. And who was standing there? Who was standing there, everyone? Pingu. Pingu, dressed like a Santa, was standing there. And Pingu said, ho, 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 Merry Christmas. Yes. Tia was so happy to see that Santa, thank you so much, you have come. I was waiting for you. Tia had made little cookies and a greeting card for Santa. And she gave it to him. Pingu was so happy to see that her sister was finally happy. Okay, I'll zoom it out. Let us just complete this outlining also, and then I'll show my complete drawing. Okay. So that you can see. Yes, this is the complete drawing. I will zoom it out. Okay, and one thing I want to tell you is that, okay, this is an important part, everyone. Please check it. Okay, those who are asking for the full screen, just wait for a minute because I have to show the eyes and they are very important part of it. Okay, so please wait for a minute and everyone, please pay attention here. We are doing the eyes part, which is very important. Okay, so in the center, you know, this circle, I will not fill the color in this inner eye, but I'll fill it in the outer one like this. And for other eye also, I'll do the same thing. Okay. So you have to fill this part and you don't have to fill in the outer part. This part you have to fill with the sketch pen. Now I will zoom it out so that you can see my complete drawing. This is my complete drawing. Right? This is the complete drawing. And now what I'll do, I'll erase all extra lines. Okay, so pick up your eraser and start erasing all the extra lines. And very carefully. Okay, and I'll blow away all the extra dust. Thank you so much, Avni. Khush, thank you. Okay, and actually, you know, this is a workshop which is okay for both. I'm going slow, but I'm doing an artwork which is little upgraded from the junior batch so that, you know, it can benefit both of you. But I'm going slow because I know junior and pre-junior kids are also there. So they should be able to do it. But, you know, when we do it in our regular classes, we do it as per the students' need. Right? So today's artwork is a mediocre of junior and senior batch. Yes. So now let us start with the coloring part. Very important part. Everyone ready to get started with the coloring? Show me a thumbs up. How many of you are excited for the coloring part? Waiting for coloring part? Yes. Let's get started. Okay. So take out your plastic crayons. Pick up your plastic crayons and you have to pick up your red color. This red color, okay? Pick up the red color, everyone. So let us start with the cap. Yes, yes, you can use, if you don't have plastic crayons, you can use wax crayons, oil pastels, whatever you have available, you can use that. Okay. So, and you know, it is not going to be normal coloring. I'll be telling you many techniques to do a 3D coloring. Okay. So it is going to be very exciting. I'll zoom it in again so that you all can see it nicely. Very important that you all notice each and every step very nicely. Okay, so for this part, I'll start with the cap. I've taken red color. Okay, this is the red color, and I'll start doing the outline. I'll start doing the outline of red color. I need to sharpen my color a little bit because I can see it is not sharp. So I'll sharpen my color, and always remember that you have to sharpen your color where? Inside the dustbin. Okay? Don't do it openly, otherwise it will spoil your work area and it will spoil your it will spoil your drawing also. Okay. Thank you so much for such wonderful compliments, everyone. I'm so happy to see that. Thank you so much. And I'm very happy that you're enjoying the class. Okay. So now, let us start with the outlining. And we will make a thick outline like this. Like I'm making a thick outline, and it will go like this. I've sharpened my color because it was going blunt, Hannah. So I've sharpened it. And now it is going so smooth. Outline it like this. And at the bottom part also, I'll outline it. And you know, we will make a thick outline, a really thick outline. Keep doing the color. And you know, when you're doing the color, make sure that white paper should not be visible in the area where you're coloring. Hannah, you have to do the coloring very nicely. The difference between plastic crayon and wax crayon is that plastic crayons are non-sticky and wax crayons are sticky. So, you know, when we color, they get deposited at some areas which spoil the look of the drawing. But when we do plastic crayons, as they are not sticky, they are spread equally and they look so good. Yes, Adir, if you have to go out, you can go and you can WhatsApp me later, okay? Because, you know, I have so many students in the class, so I cannot increase the speed too much. Otherwise, they will not be able to do. Now, the second step is that we will do light outline. Okay, lighter outline inside. One stage is darker one and the other one is lighter one. Okay? So I will do a lighter outline like this. Again, it will be thicker one. Okay, it would be thick, but it would be light also. And now, after doing this part, now in the inner part, I will do even lighter coloring. So three tones we have done for the coloring part, Hannah. A darker one, then lighter, and then completely light. Okay. And after this, what you have to do, you have to try to merge these levels. These levels are visible currently. So I'll rub the color gently around the edges and I'll try to merge it. Okay, try to merge it with so that it looks like a shade, a gradient. It does not look, it should not look like separate outlines, Anna. So this is how it should look. Okay. Okay, you want my number, just a minute. I'll write my number on a paper, okay? And I'll show it to you so that you can few of the students have to leave and they're asking for the number. And you can contact on this number right now also, okay? Sorry, very sorry for the bad handwriting. 7617410911. This is my number. Okay, everyone can note it down. You can write it down and you can take a screenshot. You have to share your artwork with me, okay? When you get completed, you have to share your artwork. I would love to see what you have done. Right? So this is my number. Please note it down. 7617410911. Yes, yes. On that number also, you can share the details on from which you got all the details. Now you can do it on that. Everyone done with this part? Yes, yes. Yes, Jivika. So I'm done with the cap. Everyone done with the cap? Show me a thumbs up if you are done. Okay. So let's shift our drawing copy and let's do the muffler part. This is the muffler of penguin and we will do the same thing we did in the cap. So what was the first step? We did thick outline. Hannah, we did thick outline. And after doing this thick outline, we will do the filling, because we do not have too much space, Hannah. In this, we do not have too much space, so we will not do the thin, the lighter outline. We will directly do the filling and we will try to mix the filling with the outline. Okay, so I have done the outline and I have done the filling part. Sure, I'll do that. Rudrakya, I'll do that. Okay, so now I'll try to merge. And how to merge? You just have to use the same color and rub it gently around the edges. And you will see that, oh, your color is getting mixed. See, this is how it would look. It would look so good. Okay, so I'm done with this part also. Now is the turn of the bag of gifts. Yes, we are taking regular classes also. Okay, those students who are interested to join the regular classes can stay after the class. Okay, stay after the class and you can WhatsApp me on this number also. This number. Please note down this number, everyone. You can WhatsApp me on this number and I'll give you all the details. Okay. And after, like by the end of this class also, after the artwork gets completed, we can discuss about the classes even in this class only. Okay. But once the artwork gets done, so that, you know, those students who want to leave or who have to rush can leave the class. Okay. So I'll be telling complete details about my classes, right? And I'll give my number again. It is 7617410911. Ashvi, please note it down. 7617410911. I've done the thick outline in this also. And I'll do the filling again. I'll fill the color again. And now I will try to merge it with Okay, and here is the bag also done. Yes, my number is 7617410911. poster colors you can use, but you know, the reason why we are not using poster color is that it is difficult to handle for younger kids, hai na? Okay, now we will start with the coloring of penguin's face. Let us get started. So first of all, you have to pick up the pink color. Now everyone must be wondering, pink color in penguin? Is penguin pink, everyone? Is it pink? No, it is not pink. Then which color is it? Is it orange color? No, it is black and white. The penguin is just like a black and white movie, hai na? But still it looks so good. Okay, so pick up the pink color and I will make the cheeks of this penguin. So I'll make a C using my pink color. Okay, I'll make another C using my pink color. And I will fill the pink color till here. I'll fill it like this. Okay. And now in the lower area, I'll start to mix the color with outside. Okay. Start to mix the color and try to merge it with outer area. Like this. Okay. This is how it should look. The number of students might increase or decrease. We might have large number of students also. Usually we have around 200, 230 students in every batch, but we might have more also. Like in this class, we had more than 900 students. Hai na? So the number might increase, but that would not affect your learning because the teaching method is absolutely the same. Okay, same I'll do for this. Okay, so now I will merge it like this. See, I have made the cheeks, the beautiful cheeks of my penguin. Hana? And now is the time to do the face part. And now let us do the face part. So to do this, I'll pick up my skin color. I'll take the skin color and I'll do very light outline. You know, very thin outline and light inner side. This side and this side. Because, you know, this part is white, but I'm giving little bit of shade. Okay. And now pick up the gray color. Pick up the gray color, everyone. Okay, if you don't have skin color, you can use the gray color also. You can use the gray color in place of the skin color. And complete this outline, okay. Complete this outline in the outer area and very thin outline. If you see, I'm not doing anything extra. I'm making a very thin outline with gray color. Okay, because many of the students were saying I don't have skin color, right? Gray color. Now I will merge this color with white. Try to do it so light that it gets merged with the white. Okay, like this. If you don't have gray color, you must be having skin color, or you can use light brown color also. If you don't have that, you can use yellow color even. You can use a yellow color also if you don't have. Okay, this is the gray color I'm using. I'm using the gray color. And I have done an outline and now I'm trying to, you know, I'm rubbing it very lightly. This technique might be new for many of you because, you know, we usually don't learn it in schools or anywhere, but this is very effective. You know, after your drawing gets completed, you will see how nice it makes your drawing look. You will be amazed to see that, oh, my drawing is looking like 3D actually. I'm doing it little bit around the eyes also. Okay, can you see just by rubbing it little bit, having little bit control on the hand and just rub it light, you will see a beautiful texture inside. That's okay. We will not be needing cello tape. If you have a Fevicol, that would also work. We will be using Fevicol, okay? Actually, we ask students to keep the cello tape because many times they don't have the bangle. So they can use cello tape in place of the bangle. And many times we need bigger circle also. So that is the reason many times we ask to have a cello tape, not to stick, but to make the circle. Because its circle is perfectly shaped. Okay. Around this eye also, I'll do it little bit. Very light. I'll do it around this eye also. And this is how the face is looking. Now, show me thumbs up if you are able to achieve this look. If you are able to do this and you're finding it easy, not difficult, then show me a thumbs up. Beautiful. You're able to do it, right? Everyone is able to do it. See, if you're finding it difficult, I'll tell you again, what you have to do is you have to rub your color very light. Beautiful. Students, beautifully done. Many students have done it so nicely. Are you happy with this effect? Are you happy with this look and effect? This is something very new that you must be trying. Very good. Okay, same I'll do. Same I will do with the body part also. In the body, you know. In this body part, beautiful. Now let's come to the body part, everyone. So in this body part also, I'll do the same. I'll do the outline with, I'll do the outline with gray color. Okay, outline like this. With gray color, and I'll try to merge it with white. Hana, I'll do it all over. Everywhere I have to do it, where I have like the upwards and downwards also. Here also, I'll simply do the outline and I'll try to merge it. That's it. Okay, and I'm done with the black part. Hi, Kekon. Okay, now let's do the black part. So to do the black part, you have to pick up your black color. Pick up your black color, everyone. Yes, you can use oil pastels. And I'll do an outline using this color. This black color I'll be doing inside. Okay. So first of all, I'm doing an outline with the black color in the nose of the penguin. Okay. And again, I'll do the thick outline. Just like we did for other areas, I will do it for this area also. That will do thick outline. And especially for this bottom part, we will make it thicker. Right? This is an activity. This is a one-day class. Okay? The workshop is going on simultaneously and my mom is taking that. Lina ma'am is taking the workshop. Now we will do light outline just like we did. Just like we did it in the cap, we will do light outline here. Okay, like this. And we'll try to merge it. And now what we will do, we will fill the gray color inside. Okay, so start filling the gray color inside. And how you have to fill the color? You have to do it in the blacker area first, and then you have to come in the lighter area. So you know what happens when we do it? If you check it, when we do it in the darker area, black color gets sticked on the gray color. And when we do it outside, it leaves its impact. So, you know, it gets mixed. It mixes the color very nicely. And I have filled it like this. And you'll see a very nice color shedding. You can merge it using black color even after doing the gray color also. You can merge it and make it look even more nice. But you will see that how nice it is looking. Hana? If you don't have gray color, you can use silver color also. And if you don't have that even, you know, do dark. Use light black only. Do the black color light. Okay? Now is the time to do the coloring in the body. Let us do the coloring in the body part. So to do the coloring in the body part, I'll pick up the black color again. In the middle, can we do black lightly? Yes, you can do the black lightly also. But if you have the gray color, it would give a very nice mixing. But if you don't want to do that, you can do black color lightly also. Okay, now pick up the black color again and I'll be doing it in this flipper. So to do it in this flipper, first of all, I'll do this time, you know, every time what I was doing the thick outline all over, right? But in flipper, I'm going to do it a little differently. And I'll show you how to do that. Okay, so yeah, actually, you know, I already told you that we have so many younger kids in this class. And we all have to move together, hana? We don't have to rush and we don't want to leave them behind. So I'm maintaining an average speed. I understand many kids are elder and they're so good at it that they're able to do it faster. I understand it. Okay? But you know, you'll have to wait for the younger ones also. Okay, so first outline I have done is outside only. I have not done it inside. The second thing, thank you so much, Kanishka. Thank you. Okay, so the second part I'll do is light outline just beside it. So I'll do it like this. Okay, gently, you have to. If you will rub it harshly, now you will never get this effect. You have to be very soft with your color to get this effect. What I'm doing a thicker outline and I have done light coloring also. So you will see different tones in my coloring, hana? And I'm trying to merge this darker tone with my lighter tone. So I'm just rubbing the color. Rubbing the color like this. See, in this drawing, if you see, I have not used gray till now, but still you can see this effect, hana? So you can continue with this. You can continue with this and you will see that even by using the black color, you are able to do it so nicely. Okay. And now again, I'll pick up the gray color and I'll do it inside and then I'll come outside. Slowly, slowly, I'll come outside. And I'll fill the color completely. And this is how your flipper would look. Yes, yes, in the workshop, she's taking cooking without fire. And in today's class, she will be teaching the how to make a Christmas tree, a craft Christmas tree she is teaching currently. Okay, so here we have got a wonderful gradient. Are you all able to get that? Show me a thumbs up if you are able to get this effect. Show me a thumbs up. You must be getting it. Very good. Amazing work. Very good. Few of the students are showing me and I'm very happy to see that. Okay, let's start with the inner part also now. Again, you know, I want to give you an example. Like, you know, I'm keeping this hand over this hand. So, you know, this part is darker, right? If you see, it is not that light. It is not that dark. But when I keep it like this, this part is looking darker. Hai na? So if I want to draw it, what I'll do, I'll make this part darker and I'll make this part lighter. Hai na? Did you get the point? By adding little bit of shadow, you can show the effect. You can show the 3D effect. And this is what we have done. Now, this flipper is kept on the body. So we will show the inner part darker and the outer part lighter. And this would give the effect of, this would give the effect of 3D. Okay. Yes, workshop is not free. Workshop is paid actually. Okay, so I'm doing the darker color inside, if you see, and I'm doing the lighter color outside, like this. I've done a little bit of lighter. And this is how. See, now it is looking like it is kept over this. That is why we did it. Okay. Thank you so much. Yes, I'll do that. Okay, now let's start with this part. We have to do black color here also. Again, I'll pick up my black color and I'll do this part darker. Okay, and I'll do this part lighter. You know, those who do not have gray color, they will do it like this. I'll show you. They will do it like this. It is absolutely the same. Okay. I have not used gray color, but I've done the lighter color. Yes, you can join the workshop. You can call on the number I gave you and you can join if you want. I'll tell you after the class. We are about to get done with this drawing and then I'll tell you how to join the class also. Okay. So now I will be filling gray color. And if you don't have gray color, you can leave it like this. Right. I've filled the gray color and now the final coloring in the last flipper is left. So I'll again fill the darker color. I hope you got the point, the concept that we are using to fill it. Okay. And now I will again fill the light color. Like this. Okay, so I'm done with all the black coloring part, right? Now the beak is left. We have to fill the color in the beak also. So take out the orange and yellow color. The beak is yellow and orange. So we will do the same color. Pick out, I've taken out my orange and my yellow color. Okay. I don't know Bengali. I'm very sorry. I can speak only in Hindi and English. These are the two languages I know. Yes, yes, yes. Srishti, you can. Okay. Yes. Now, first of all, I'll do the orange color in the lower part of the beak. to the orange color in the lower part of the beak, and for upper part of the beak we will do the same coloring, same technique that we have been using everywhere. That I'll do a thick coloring, thick outlining. First do the thick outline, then do the thin out, light outline, and then do the yellow color. What we did the thick outline, dark outline of orange color here, then we did the light outline of orange color, and now I will be doing yellow color. Okay, I'll try to merge it, and here is my beak also done, right? Now let us do it in the feet also. For the feet also, I will do the same thing, that I will do it in the lower part like this. Okay, in all the lower parts I'll make a C like this, and in rest of the part I will again do the yellow color. Okay, so pick up the yellow color and I will fill the yellow color in rest of the parts, and this is how it would look. Okay, this is the complete. Ashlesha, whatever doubt you have, you can put it in the chat box. Okay. And yes, Aheli, yes, you can. Okay, I'm done with my penguin. Now, a very important part of my penguin is still left. And what is that? Those are the eyes. The eyes of my penguin are still left. And to do the eyes part, I have taken this dark blue color. Pick up this dark blue color and make sure it is really sharp. Okay? I did not get your question, Radhika. Please share and send your question again. I'll answer it. In this part, you know, in this part, outer part, I will fill this blue color. Only in the outer part, okay? Like this. And for this eye also, I will fill blue color in the outer part. And with this, I have used blue color. No, we are not going to leave it blank. We will be filling some color. Okay, so I have filled this dark blue color in the eye, and you will see how much it is adding to the drawing, hai na? Deep blue. Yes, you can do that. You can, if you don't have dark blue, you can fill light blue. If you don't have that, you can use purple color also. That would also look good, right? So now I can say that I'm done with my drawing. Now is the time. Okay, first of all, this lower part, this is snow, so this would be white. Okay, now I will be filling color in my Christmas trees. So, we get this ocean green color. We get this ocean green color with our plastic crayons. Do you have it? Yes. Okay. So if you don't have ocean green color, see, these are the green colors we get. So this has little more blue tint. Hai na? So if you have this color, you can use this, or you can use the dark green color also. Any color that you have. Okay. So any color you have, you can use that. And you have to fill it in the Christmas trees at the back. Okay, I'm going to fill the color in the back. So just outline it nicely, and we will be filling flat coloring. We are not going to do anything extra, any shading in this. We will just do the flat coloring in it. Okay. because they are far, hai na? So that is why we don't have to. And you know, in winter's time, it is really foggy also, right? Yes, yes, I'll do that. Himanshi, I'll do that. Okay, so I have filled dark green color. And now, I have filled dark green color in the trees, brown color, as we always do in the trunk. Okay, here also in the trunk, I'll do the brown color. Fill brown color all over the trunk. And for this Christmas tree, I will do the dark green color again. Okay, so I'm not telling the story now because, you know, we have to. Yes, yes, that is the name of our channel, My Creative Mom, Leena Bandil. Thank you so much, Ashvi. Okay, now I will do the dark green color. And to do the dark green color, I will again do the outlining. Okay, I'll start with the outlining. In the Christmas tree also, I'm going to add little bit of shading. So first of all, I will do the dark green color outline. Okay, do the outline very nicely. Like this. Okay. And after this outline, the name of my channel is My Creative Mom, Leena Bandil. I actually created that channel for my mom and I could not think of any other name. So I just named it My Creative Mom, Leena Bandil. And now it is so famous. Okay, so the name of the channel is My Creative Mom, Leena Bandil. Okay, I'll go a little slow. So, you know, first I did dark outline outside. Okay, and now I'm doing light outline inside. Actually, you know why we cannot paint in this particular drawing? Because we have done black sketch pen outline, hai na? And if water drop falls on it, na, it will spread. It will start spreading and it will spoil the look of our drawing. Okay. So, I'll do light outlining inside. Around the balls, you can do the dark outline. Okay. I'm doing the light outlining inside the... And I'll almost fill it. This is how it would look. And now try to merge it. Okay, try to merge it a little bit. And this is how your Christmas tree should look. We will not do any other color inside. I have just done this green color. Okay. The drawing is already zoomed out. And you know, if I'll zoom it out completely, students will not be able to see it. Now pick up the red color. And you know, these little lights, let us do the red color just in the outline. Just like this. And leave a small circle inside. Okay, leave a small circle, tiny circle of white color inside and fill red in rest of the area. Like this. Okay, it would give a very nice effect of light. Kakun, you are not doing? Okay, now let us fill the yellow color. I'll tell you, the cotton part is the secret part. We'll do it in the end after completing the, when we will get done the, with the coloring completely, then we will do the cotton part. Okay, so now I'm done with this part also. Now the background is left. Okay, the background part is left. So I will pick up the blue color. I'll pick up the sky blue color and I'll do it in the sky. Okay, in the background, I'll do this sky blue color. Okay, now I'll rotate my copy like this. Okay, here you can see the complete view and I'll do it in the background. Yes, yes, I'm trying to finish it by 3 p.m. Okay, I'm trying my best to finish it by 3 p.m. So let us do the background coloring and I'm doing the outline around. I'm doing the outline around the paper also. Okay. And you have to do the coloring like this. Okay. Make sure when you do it around the shape, else you can do big, big strokes. And this is how. And you know, at the edges part, at this edges part, always do the outline. Very important part. Always do the outline at the edges part. So that, you know, when you will do the coloring now, it won't look bad and it would not disturb you at all. Otherwise, it is very disturbing when we do the coloring. Na? It disturbs us at the edges and it spoils the whole coloring. But here, we are doing the light blue color. And like, this is the part which is white. So, I'll do it carefully around it. I'll create an outline, okay? I'll create the outline and then I will do it. I'm trying to make my color even more even. Okay, this is how it should look. Okay, here also I'll do the same color. I'll do the same color here also. At this part. Okay, so again, first of all, I'll do it around the paper. Let us do around the paper, very important part. Okay, and around the outline of the penguin also. Because white part is inside, right? So we don't want to spoil that part. And now I will do. Now I will fill the color in the background. And you know, while filling the color, always remember that your color should go in one direction. Okay, it should not be in random direction. If you see, if you notice, I have done all sleeping lines, hai na? I have never done a coloring in random directions. If you will do it in different directions, na, it will spoil the look of the drawing. You will see when the drawing gets completed that it is not looking that nice just because the strokes were done here and there. But when you do the strokes in one line, it gives amazing look. Okay, so I'm done with, this is how my complete drawing is looking. And now the cotton part is left. Now the cotton part is left and we have very less time left also. Is everyone ready to do the cotton part? Show me a thumbs up if you are ready to start with the cotton part. Yes, yes, the craft part is left, I know. So, take the cotton. I've got a big cotton loaf now, okay? And pick up your fevicol also. And you know, in this white part, I have to stick the cotton. So, add fevicol in this part. I'll add fevicol in this part. And I'm using a nodal one and adding it all over. Okay. See, I have added the cotton, the fevicol like this. Everyone can see it? Okay. And now I will take the cotton and I'll stick it here. I'll try to make a shape like this and I will stick my cotton. I'll adjust it and I'll try to stick it here like this. Okay, in this part, I will add, you know, you can keep using fevicol and cotton, add more cotton so that it looks even more nice. And I have added the cotton. Okay, if you don't have cotton, that is also fine. That is completely fine if you don't have cotton. You can leave it like this also. This is also looking very good. Now I will add the cotton in this area. So again, I will add fevicol in this area. And I'm adding the fevicol in this part, especially at the outline. Do it nicely. Okay, like this. And again, I'll show you. I have added fevicol all over. Can you see it? Yes. And now I will again add small cotton. I'll try to make that shape with small cotton. Try to add that shape and add it. Okay, like this. At the edge also, I'll try to adjust the shape. You know, in this lower and upper area also, as I can see here, little bit of cotton is required more. So I will add a little bit of cotton in this area. We will be talking after the class, okay? let the class get over. I want to complete the artwork so that, you know, those who have their classes and they want to leave, they can leave. And after this, I'll be discussing about the classes also. Right? So we have done it till here. Now, where is the snow part? This is the snow part. So we will be adding cotton here also. First, I'll add some cotton just below the tree and just below the penguin also. I'll add some cotton. This would give a very nice effect to it. Okay, so I'm adding little bit of cotton on the paper just to add a 3D look on my drawing. And I'm adding little bit of cotton just near where the penguin is standing. So this would also add a very nice look to my drawing. Okay, and add small pieces of cotton. No need to add a bigger one. Okay, and for rest of the area, I will add the fevicol randomly like this. Okay, so if you see, I have added, please switch to speaker's view. I have added the fevicol like this in other area. Hana? And now I will be adding flat cotton. So I'll take the cotton and I'll flatten it like this. And I'll keep adding it randomly. I just have to add random cotton here. There's no need to make it very specific or perfectly done, okay? That is completely fine because it is snow and it is lying like this only. So we have to give that same effect. Okay, so I will be adding cotton in this area. Okay, add cotton, more cotton. Randomly and keep using small pieces. See, students, I'm not using the big ones. Yes, Avni, you can. Okay, I'll add little bit of cotton in this area also because this is also left. I'll add little bit of cotton here also. Okay. And now, if you want, we can make small balls of cotton and add it in the background to show the snowfall. So, I'll make small balls of cotton like this. And I can add it in the background to show the snowflake. Okay. So, I'll add fevicol drops. And not too many. Don't add too many, just few of them. Because, you know, we have already added too much of cotton. Huh? So it won't look good if we add too many balls. Right? So add very less amount of snowballs. Right? I'm making them and I'm putting them. Make small circles. Very small. And add the snowflakes. Okay, and with this, our drawing would be completed. I hope you all enjoyed the drawing. Can you all show me your drawing once? Bring it close to the camera, everyone. Very close to the camera so that I can see. Everyone, please show me your drawing. Very nice. beautiful penguin you all have created. That's so good. Very nice. I can see many of you have added your personal touch also, and it is looking so good. So this is the complete drawing. This is our complete drawing. Can you all see it? I have added the snowflakes also. And this is our complete drawing. Beautifully you all have done. I'm so happy to see your artworks. So how many of you enjoyed the class? And you know, I want to show you again. This is what we did in the last class. We learned a Santa and we added cotton here also. We added the cotton at the bottom and we added it here also. And this is the artwork we did in today's class. Okay, so now I'll be telling you about the regular classes also. First of all, I'll show you some of the artworks that we did in the last class. Okay, I'll show you some of the artworks. This is, you know, in regular classes. In regular classes, we are doing very simple stuff. This drawing was, yes, this Santa drawing you will find on YouTube. This is a honeybee that we learned in the last class. Okay, this is a honeybee resting with its parents. This is a birthday drawing that we did. Three owls celebrating birthday. Okay, and I'll show you more drawings. So, you know, we have classes. We learned Doraemon also. We learned Doraemon also in the class. This is for younger kids I'm showing. Okay, and this is for pre-junior batch. We learned this very easy a form of kids playing the drawing. Okay, then we did a picnic drawing also. We did picnic drawing also where the family, whole family is playing the, going for a picnic. And we did Captain America. Yes, yes, you can join. Most welcome those who want to join the regular classes. And this is also a drawing we did. Okay, I'll show you more drawings. You know, this is Ganpati we did. At the time of Ganesh Chaturthi, we did the Ganpati. And this is Krishna we learned during this love. We did it in junior batch and this we learned in at Janmashtami. Yes, yes, I'll show a super senior batch, I'll tell you. Just a minute. Okay, and we did it in junior batch also. So now I'll tell you about the complete classes. Okay. This is my number, first of all. Please note it down. 7617410911. Okay, this is the number. And the cost for regular classes is 1,000 rupees for 1 month. Okay, this is the cost for regular classes. And we have our Christmas offers also going on, which is for 4,000 rupees. 4,000 rupees for 6 months. This is a discounted price, and we have 7,000 rupees for 12 months. You know, most of the students are enrolled with us for long term because, you know, if you want to see the improvement, you have to go for, like, you have to learn for at least 6 months or 1 year so that you can really improve. Okay, now I'll tell you about the batches also. Okay, and if you want to enroll, all the updates, the website is artjio.com. This is the website. You can click a picture of this, okay? This is the website where you will find all the details. I'll show my face also. I'll show my face. We'll talk. Okay. My name is Ayushi. Okay. And the batches we have are pre-junior, which is for 3 to 5 years. Okay. Junior batch. Which is for 5 to 9 years. Then we have senior batch, which is for 10 to 15 years, and super senior batch, super senior, which is for 15 plus and moms. Okay, this batch is for super senior and moms. Okay, so you can take the picture of this. This is the complete thing. Okay. So please note it down. These are all the details of about our classes. And if you have any doubt, okay, one more thing, that all the students have to share their details with me on this number. Okay, about the time and everything, you can WhatsApp me on this number. I'll provide you all the details. You can do it right now. And as I know that you all have completed your artwork, hold your artwork in your hands, give a big, big smile and share it with me. Okay, share it on WhatsApp with me. In 1 month, we do 7 classes. You know, in 1 month, we do 14 classes in 1 month and 7 artworks. Matlab, in one class, we do drawing and in other class, we do coloring. And it is a 1 hour class. Every class is a 1 hour class. Like today's class was really long. So usually the classes are 1 hour classes. Okay. Anything else you want to ask? You all have to share your photo on this number. I really want to see, because you know, you all have our numbers, okay? And the timings, I'll tell you, I'll provide you the timings also. There are different time slots for all age groups. And we have 2 time slots for junior batch. So I'll tell you the time slot. Please WhatsApp me on this number. I'll provide you all the details. Okay? I'll turn on the camera now. Yes, am I visible to all of you now? Hi, everyone. Hello. Okay, so you got all the details. Did you enjoy the class? Show me a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Give me a big thumbs up. Okay. I'm so happy to see all of you. Thank you so much for being a part of this drawing class. I was very happy. Can you please show me your drawing? Everyone, please show me your drawing. I can see so many of students are still busy doing beautiful. Very good. Ishan, Anurag, Aniket. Actually, you know, I can see all of you. Mishul, Vansh, Udantika, beautiful name, Prisha, Rishta, and Chandan, Khurana, Drishti, Bani and Gauri and Mridulatha and Shreyasi, Porvi. Beautiful. You all have done amazing. Thank you so much, everyone. Bye bye. I'm leaving the class now. Bye. Bye bye. Take care. And thank you so much for being a part. You all have the number, right? Okay. So you have to WhatsApp me on that number, right? Okay. Bye bye. Take care.